world. Michael Beasley here coming to you from the Dreamer's Corner. Episode 6. We are back. And as you've seen with the opening segment, the Olympics are here. Is here, are here, however you want to put it. He, she, we, I don't know. It is what it is. But the Olympics are here. And especially with everything that's been going on in the world with the Delta variant, the coronavirus, states getting shut back down, masks being mandated, whether you're vaccinated, not vaccinated, just the craziness of the world going on, we have the Olympics. And the Olympics is special just in general. You got to take into account you have athletes from all across the world representing their country. Some with the weight of an entire country on their shoulders. Which brings me to my first topic of the day. Simone Biles. Now, Simone Biles has been discussed heavily from this first week of the Olympic Games. She pulled out of her events due to mental health concerns. Now, many people across the world had a lot of media had a lot to say about this, along with social media and Twitter and the Karens of Facebook and such. Much of social media had some input to this, and a lot of it was negative, and some of it was positive as well. But a lot of the negative, I just want to say this off tops. If you are new to the Olympic Games, understand this. Simone Biles is a prized Olympian. Simone Biles was a victim of Larry Nassar. Understand that what I just said there. She is not only just a prized Olympian, she has 4 gold medals and 4 gymnastic moves named solely after her because nobody's ever done them before. There's never been anybody like Simone Biles in gymnastics. She is the GOAT at 24 years old. The GOAT. Now, I watched her this week, and watching her, I knew something was off. You could see it in her face, in her eyes, in her movement, in her expressions. When she finished the move, it was sloppy. But she was still better than the other people. She still finished better being bad. And that's a fact. So when she pulls out of her event after she does a move, and she pulls out right afterwards because she didn't land it how she wanted to. She said, I don't think I can do this right now. Something like that. I don't remember exactly word for word what she said. I'm not going to say I know what she said. But I'm going to say this. She does moves that nobody else in this world can do. And when you're a gymnast, and when you are a gymnast and do flips and bars and all this stuff that I know I can't do, but I envy those who can do it. But there's a level of concern there because you can kill yourself doing that. If you're not in the right state of mind, Q found that. Next up, I sent my confidant Edward Guacamole to North Korea to get some exclusive footage of the statue of Kim Jong-un. I hear it's pretty big, but he's not very big, but I hear the statue's big. Let's check it out.
This is it.
So when you are bowing, please keep your hands at your sides.
To be honest, it was quite strict there. You can't sit down. I couldn't film a lot of it, even though I got a bit. And if you take a picture of the statue, you have to get the whole thing in shot. You can't like crop in or like zoom into his head or something.
Unfortunately, Edward didn't make it back to America. Edward is currently in a North Korean prison camp. I don't have the money to get him out. Actually, even if I did have the money, he still wouldn't be able to get out. They took his camera. He sent me that footage, though. I did get that. They took his camera. Basically, what happened was, is some random person sent me this footage, said, it wrote on the letter, footage. I don't know. It just showed up at my house. It really just showed up. But I did have an address for Edward. If anybody would like to speak with him, like just send him letters and stuff, because you know, being in jail, it probably sucks really bad, especially a prison camp in North Korea. But you can get him at Edward Guacamole, number D3AD. And that is at North Korean prison camp. Zip code 8888888887. Also, I did hit up President Biden. He didn't get back to me. I think he's still in the basement. Next up, the crazy jackasses of Jackass have finally come to terms of that they're just jackasses. And we get a Jackass 4. Jackass 4, starring Johnny Knoxville, Steve-O, Wee Man, and all them other crazy dudes. And basically, these guys have finally decided they're not too old to be jackasses. So what are they going to do? Be jackasses. However, one person will be missing from the show, and he is an original Bam Margera. No, he's not dead. Bam is alive, and I have an exclusive interview with Bam right now. Bam, you there? Bam, how you doing, man?
Fuck, man. I'm not in Jackass 4. If anybody cares about me...
Oh, don't be like that, Bam. I care about you, man. We all care about you. You were funny.
Don't go see their movie, because I will make mine way fucking radder if you just Venmo me a dollar. Just a buck.
I mean, I can send you a dollar, bro. That's not a problem. I got a dollar.
If you send $100, I'll remember your name and write it down in Strigley.
$100, you kind of reasonable.
Damn. Then more than that, and I'll do more. Yeah.
Crack, man.
10 pound is some fucking... Jackass was everything to me.
Damn. Cut it.
No, I'm cut so it. Relieved.
Fine, cut it. Just... Well, since that didn't go so well, I sent Clyde to an exclusive meet and greet with Butterbean to see if he's going to be in the new Jackass 4 movie.
Jackass, no, Jackass. I'm Butterbean. I was in Jackass.
Hey, let me hit you in the face for $250, Jackass.
I'm going to hit you. I'm not a Jackass. A $250 don't mean nothing.
Listen, buddy, I'm making it. It's a joke.
I don't care if it's a joke or not.
Next up, Predator Send It.
You've got mail.
Welcome to Predator Send It. I have actually asked Baby Yoda to join me because of such great reviews we got last time. Baby Yoda joined the show. Baby Yoda, how you been? Dope. First up, Florida man in bubble washes up on shore. What do you think, Baby Yoda? Yeah. Print it. A Florida man washed ashore inside a bubble-like vessel on Saturday morning after an apparent attempt to walk on water. The seafarer, identified as Reza Belushi of Central Florida, was attempting to run his floating bubble vessel from Florida to Bermuda or travel north up the coast to raise money for charity. However, upon setting off for New York from St. Augustine area, he encountered complications that brought him back to shore. He was doing this all to raise money for charity. Well, good for you. Good for you. However, I mean, it's kind of cool getting in a bubble boy, but man, the ocean was not made for man. That's all I got to say about that. Number two, $50 billion deposited into bank account. Print it. Louisiana couple shocked after bank mistakenly deposits $50 billion into bank account. Darren James, 47, said he arrived home from work in Baton Rouge when his wife showed him what appeared to be a deposit for the huge sum of money on her smartphone. I'm like, where did that come from? James said. And all we were thinking was who's going to be knocking on our door, because we don't know anybody with that type of money to begin with. The family immediately contacted Chase. Chase was notified of the error, fixed the problem, and they are no longer billionaires. $50 billion? I mean, y'all could have took a little bit of that and just took off for the islands. Just said, fuck it. That's what I did. For real. I mean, I took $1 billion. I'm not selfish or nothing. I took $1 billion. What's wrong with being a billionaire? There's not very many of them. I can still be a billionaire. I'll let y'all have the other 49 billion. I don't think that's wrong. Fabiola, what you think? Would you take $50 billion or 49? Or just one? Would you take $50 billion or $1 billion?
Hell yes.
Number 3. Sex doll rescued from lake. Send it.
You've got mail.
Number 4. Jetpacks got... What? Jetpack guy sighting in Los Angeles. Clyde, are you serious, man? Clyde. You ain't being real, right? Baby Yoda... Clyde, don't play with me, dude. Go right Edward, bro. Go right Edward. Jetpack guy may have been spotted soaring over California. Apparently, this man has been mistaken as a UFO plenty of time. The pilots apparently said, "We were looking, but we did not see Iron Man." They're wondering if this guy really exists or not. Nobody knows who he is. But it also, they think it could be a drone. However, it resembles a person. So right now, they just don't really know. It's kind of like that thing I told you about UFOs before. Are they real? I know you're real, man. It's them that don't know how to handle toilet paper. Not y'all. The other people.
We just wanna party, party just for you. We just wanna party, party just for you.
Next up, we have a brand new segment coming to the Dreamers Quarter entitled Chooch of the Week. Let's check it out. Chooch! 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 Fucking chooch.
Yeah, there you go, bro. I'm gonna grab it at the bottom. Ooh,
because y'all scratching it all up.
Time to think we gotta listen.
Somebody should be on the inside with wood. Darrell, what are you doing?
I'm trying to help lift. One, two, no,
nothing,
three.
I promise you.
I don't
want to. He ain't doing anything at all.
Come on.
Darrell,
come on,
that's terrible. Y'all should be, you should be helping.
Mom, look
stuff.
At me.
You ain't
Mom,
doing nothing.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, ooh.
Come on. You got in there softly. Move.
Nah, you gotta lift up. Yeah.
Thank y'all for watching the episode. My name is Michael Beasy. It was a pleasure. I hope y'all please like, subscribe, share, comment. Again, like, subscribe, share, comment. Also, tune into the Olympics. It's awesome. It's literally everything you can imagine and more. The Olympics makes a difference in life, just in general. Also, gooses. Get goosebumps from them. The Olympics will give you goosebumps. But other than that, you know I like to end things with a quote. True life is lived when tiny changes occur. Lee Tolstoy. Until next time, y'all. Peace.